This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Over 40% of our state's agriculture output is dairy. But slowly, some of the state's dairies are shutting down. Farmers blame high production costs and lower prices for their products. Alice Massimi recently spent some time with area dairy farmers to learn more.
We reach into our fridge almost every day to grab it. We use it on our cereal, and it makes cookies taste even better. It's milk. Many of us use it without thinking where it came from, and the answer goes beyond the grocery store. Meet Bill and Karen Boyd, fourth-generation farmers.
It's my life. It's what I do. I live it. Not only it's our leisure is even farming.
7 days a week, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, Bill and Karen tend to their 45 cows and more than 800 acres of crops. They say it's a tough way to make a living that recently has gotten even tougher.
The milk prices come up a little, but the feed prices are going up proportionately.
Low milk prices top the list of concerns, but you'll also find increased production costs and loss of farmland on farmers' minds these days.
Development is definitely pushing a lot of the farmers out. Even here at our home farm, in a couple years when I look out my barn door in the morning, I'm going to see condominiums and townhouses.
Many farmers can now make more money selling their land than farming it.
They're getting older, they worked all their lives, and they just realize maybe they want to enjoy life a little more.
And with less children wanting to take over their family's businesses, the amount of farms in the area is drastically shrinking. 10 years ago, there were more than 130 farms in Lehigh County. The latest numbers show there's 25. Northampton County has lost more than 100 dairy farms, and Berks County had close to 1,000. At last check, there are only 300.
We're just a small percentage of what we used to be. You know, here in Lehigh County, there are very few of us anymore. So it's a dying breed, you know.
Hubert Sell is a fourth-generation farmer in Northampton County. His sons now run the family business, Crystal Spring Farm. The family farms more than 300 acres of land and has 300 cows. He says milk prices and the higher cost of producing it is forcing many farmers to close their doors. Hubert explains the cost to produce 1 pound of milk averages 13 cents. Until recently, farmers were only being paid 12 cents per pound, a price set by the USDA and the Pennsylvania Milk Marketing Board.
If the cost of production would go up, our milk price would go up, and they're refusing to do it. So it's a big challenge for the farmers. To, you know, with the extra cost of production, being compensated for that, and it doesn't look good.
I hate to say this to a consumer, but it's going to have to go up, or the costs are going to have to go down, and you know that costs don't go down.
Scott explains everything from the price of diesel fuel used to operate farm equipment to cattle feed to the cost of containers has skyrocketed.
I just heard a story the other day. A guy had a 600 cows, and he was buying in all his feed, and he was losing $40,000 a month. So all the cows are gone, the farm's for sale.
Not wanting to have a similar fate, Scott says he and his family have concentrated on becoming self-sufficient. They're also not relying on milk to make a living anymore.
We decided that maybe we should try to determine our own destiny.
In the 1970s, Crystal Spring Farm decided to diversify their business. They opened up a grocery store and a cafe. The cafe is called Tulips Cafe, where you can get everything from a cold glass of fresh milk to some of their homemade ice cream.
The milk, you know, when you make a whole bunch of things out of that milk, whether it be ice cream or different flavors of milk and everything, there is more profit in that than just having a truck come in here and going to Lando Lakes and getting that $15 a hundredweight for that milk, which it currently is at.
U.S. Representative Charlie Dent hopes to make life easier for farmers like these. He's working with other lawmakers to make sure the newly proposed farm bill provides support to Pennsylvania's farmers.
Pennsylvania is a great dairy producing state and will continue to be. We'll do all we can to try to maintain these dairy farms.
The Boyds and the Sells say they just want to overcome their challenges and continue to provide quality, locally grown products. For Tempo, I'm Alice Massimi reporting.